Whoa. That's cool.
3, 2, 1, go.
So this is an auto rigging tool. So let's see what it looks like. So it looks pretty cool. I have no idea about rigging. I've never tried to rig. So I'm gonna try it out for the first time and we're just gonna see how it goes. I don't know what I have to do with my models or anything like that. I don't know how to retopologize. All right, so I'm gonna jump to my PC and I'm gonna go to AccuRig website and download the app. AccuRig, download free. Okay, I agree. Install, finish. All right, please sign in. Okay, looks like we're in.
We're in. Yeah.
Load character, compatible poses and extras. A pose, I don't even know if I have any characters like this. Symmetrical A pose or T pose is optimal for auto detection. Multi meshes and accessories are allowed. Total poly count should be under 600K. Okay, so I think I might need to make a character that fits these specs. Okay, so right now I am sculpting in Nomad Sculpt on an iPad Pro M2. And yes, I did upload this full process as a tutorial here on my YouTube. So if you want to sculpt along, or if you want to sculpt something similar, or you just want to see how I sculpt and how I went about making this character, specifically in a T-pose to use in AccuRig. So now I'm just going to send this guy to the computer. So choose file, AccuRig X FBX, open. It's importing my model. It's importing my model. This is exciting. Okay, looks good, I think. Check model. I think the model is checked. I don't know what else to do here. Rig body. Body rig. There's dots on it, baby. There's dots on it. Can I like move? Oh, okay. So I can scroll in and out. Okay. Oh, so this is like the elbow. I think that's like the elbow. I think that's right. This should be the wrist. So the wrist is here. This is the shoulder. So we'll put that here. It's probably going to bend these things. I'm not sure. Oh, wait, is it not? Oh, no, it's not symmetrical. Symmetry. I want everything. Oh, okay. It's symmetrical now, but I have to move everything a little bit just to make sure. Okay, good. So that's the wrist. What is this? This is the neck base. I'll put that here. I think I have to put it underneath, but can I rotate it? What is this though? Oh, yeah. Okay. So this is the neck base. That's like here. Okay. What is this? This is the place at the clavicle joint. I guess that would be like here. Oh, what's going on with the face? Ooh, what is this? This is the place at the neck tip, neck base, neck tip. Okay. So I need to find the top of the neck. I think that's here. This is the thigh hip joint, the center of the pelvis. So that's actually in a good spot, I think. The knee joint is here. This is fun. I just need to move it up. Oh, there we go. Okay, not bad. Oh, that's easier. It's easier to use those things. Ankle joint. That's probably like a pretty good spot. And this is the toe base, the base of the toe. Joint size. Oh, that's all of them. Okay. Just kidding. I see a thing that says rig right hand, so maybe we have to rig that by itself. All right, rig right hand. 4. But I didn't even see the things though. Oh, maybe it's making the little circles. Okay. Parallel to the index finger. I feel like this is probably pretty good. What are these? The joints of the same finger should be parallel. It only has, okay, so I need to figure out how to take one away. How do I do that? Let's right click. Nope. X. Let's try X. Nope. Let's try backspace. Nope. Can I drag them into each other? Nope. Is there any like garbage or something? Trash can I can bring it to? Okay, so you know what? I'm just going to bring it like, I guess, outside of the thing. What is this? The cone should be perpendicular to the thumb. Oh, yeah, it is. It is, baby. Holla. Rig left hand. So the only issue is there's like an extra node here. Okay. All right. I can't really move it that well, though, can I? I guess it just has to be pointing backwards, I guess. This is wild. All right, so it's calculating. It's doing its thing. I should have just did a more. Whoa. That's cool. The only problem is, why is the... this hand is good. It's not going through the leg, but this one is... It's like going through the leg. And it's symmetrical, so why would one side be messed up and the other side not? I should do a pose like that. That's probably the better way to do it. I feel like it was this one that was like a little messed up. I wish I could rotate it a little better, but maybe that'll work. All these other things are back though. These other nodes. What happens if you click advanced? Applying skin wets. I like it as the male and the female sways. Oh, I guess I can't. I was going to get a piece of candy, but I guess I can't. Oh, no. The fingers, no. Fingers are all messed up. Like, it was like not perfect, but it was better before. He looks so silly. Oh, is that a T pose? Is that how I should have done it? Okay, well, I might play around a little bit with this pose offset. What is all this? Oh, and it does, it changed those things too. Okay, so, Anyway, let's export it and see what happens. Export. Oh, I don't know what all this stuff is. Anyway, so that's cool. I'm gonna have to, can I do some other things? Okay. Oh, it didn't do anything. Oh, these are just poses. Oh, they're going in the face. I think it's reading the thumb as like not really a thumb. I think that's what the situation is. Okay. All right. Don't hurt nobody. Okay, let's go back to body. I liked this one. This is actually really, really cool. Shout out to AccuRig. What's up, guys? Thank you so much for watching the video. Be sure to like and subscribe. And also check out my Skillshare. I have a brand new class. It's going to be the full pipeline of Nomad Sculpt to Blender. So this is a great class if you've been working in Nomad for a while and you're ready to bring it to that next step with beautiful Blender renders. Keep drawing, keep sculpting. And I look forward to seeing you in the next one.